why mackerel in like this, the industry, like, you know what I mean?
Dude, I'm actually so tired. I feel like I got like 2 hours of sleep last night.
We got good sleep.
We're gonna be on the beach soon.
Yeah, just yeah, think about the beach.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
20 minutes.
Then, like, where should we start this dialogue?
My name's Brian Lee. I'm a chef looking for new opportunities to cook outdoors and create the connection between communities and the source of their ingredients. For our pilot episode, we're heading to Midcoast Maine by the Damariscotta River to talk to Max and Sarah about their small fishery, Maine mackerel. This is Dinner Bell.
We're like, let's see if we can do this, period, because fish isn't sold this way. Like, a lot of fish is like this huge commodity volume product, and we're like, is there interest in the market to buy, to like know your fishermen, like know who's going out there, who's killing the fish, who's bringing it in, who's icing it? Is that interest out there? Like, do people want that, and do they want that connection with their food?
People who ended up buying shares from us this year, and a lot of the restaurants that buy in, that are part of this, that choose to be a part of this, almost all like people who just absolutely love that these fish and like having the capacity to like be close with their food in this way. So it's really about that short chain. I think it's about the short chain as much as possible.
What if you could handle each fish one by one? What if you could kill each fish individually and care for it and respect it in a way that is not in like a super like pretentious hokey way, but just like get Maine people Maine fish, like get them fish from the water that they're like swimming in or playing in or boating in or whatever, just for that more of a connection to your food. And like, we just wanted it so bad and we're so hungry for it. And we're like so moved by the idea of people being into this like hyper local fish, just because typically, you know, mackerel is a bait fish and it doesn't have a lot of value, but it takes some time, or has taken some time, to find the right match of the right person who will understand what it's all about. Because it's really nice to be able to like open up the cooler and people be like, wow, like they're so beautiful, because they are.
Brian caught a couple of them.
Oh, did you?
I was more so part of the like processing part. I was like head down, like Max had just showed me how he does it, and maybe one or two fish, and next thing that like eight more would drop in the basket.
But this is a bonus that they're cleaned and processed, so thanks for that.
Yeah, of course. Full circle. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
We get such good produce, why can't we get good fish? And like, it was like a blessing having like Max come in every week off the boat with like a load of fish, and people love it.
Right.
And there's such a huge farm scene on land in Maine, where like you have your farmers markets and you meet your farmers and stuff like that, and it isn't so much the case for fish. That's sort of what we strive for.
So we headed to meet Alex at Pemaquid Farm to pick our produce for the meal and chat more about the local agriculture scene.
In Damariscotta, there was a piece of land, like a huge piece of land very close to the the downtown area, and a Walmart was making a push to go in there. The town like had a meeting, put an emergency ordinance in that wouldn't allow any building over, I think it was 20,000 square feet, which essentially like wouldn't allow any of these big chains to come in. And then they did a GoFundMe, and a local farm bought the land or so.
Yeah,
instead
yeah,
of a Walmart, we have a farm.
It's a bald eagle, dude. I've never seen, look, it's right above us. And as a thank you, I wanted to cook a meal for the community that I met during my time here. The menu that I came up with is a reflection of my experience in Maine. I made roasted carrots that I served with coriander chutney, beets with charred onion aioli and soft herbs, and a summer caprese salad with stone fruit and heirloom tomatoes, local ribeye, butter basted with simple herbs and garlic, and of course, the Maine mackerel that I grilled and served with chimichurri.
Mackerel.
This is Brian Lee.
This is Sarah.